Hello, this is Yannis from Any Repair. Today we will go over a dead notebook that came to us from another lab that already worked on. Let's go and see what is the fault. Now we are in the upper overhead view. We can see that I have connected the power supply, but the DC cable is unplugged. This is because of the short that is present on the notebook. In our notebook's main rail, if I connect the DC cable, the notebook will consume 5 amps. We will check about it later. Now, let's see the DC connector. We have 3 pins together as the positive pin, 1 middle pin and 2 pins together as the ground. If we follow the path of the positive, we will meet a filter. If we check on the filter for short, there is a dead short. Now we must make sure that there is no short in a coil. Because if an upper MOSFET in a buck converter is broken, may transfer the main rail voltage on the load and kill the load. This load could be a CPU, GPU or PCH. In our case, it is a CPU. We'll check for short the coils just to be sure that we're not working in vain. We will go over all coils to check for similar dead shorts as in the main rail. So, we have no shorts on the coils, so we can proceed for further testing. Another way to check for main rail short is to check the ceramic capacitors that are filtering the main rail beside of any upper MOSFET. You see that here someone already worked on the board but couldn't solve the case. We can see clearly that the caps around the first, the upper MOSFET are shorted. Now that we have cleared the no coil short, we can connect the power supply and the DC cable to see the consumption. You can see that instantly when we plug the power supply, the consumption was 5 amps. The sideboard, of course, is clear from source. And now we must inject voltage in order to find out where the short is. We have the board out of the chassis. We have soldered a common DC jack. To the positive to the main rail and the negative to the screw pad. We have set our voltage to 1 volt just to go slow and safe. And we have approximately 1.5 amps at 1 volt. We will use our thermal camera to check where the burning hotspot is. Let's go to the screen capture, and that's our thermal camera view. We inspect the board, and we will adjust some sensitivity thermal colors of the thermal camera to be more precise, and we will sit down here near the CPU, probably a capacitor that is burning. We will change to the normal camera view, and yes, it is a capacitor that is filtering the main rail. Now we will switch the microscope, and we can see that the short is in the area that a technician has already worked for the case, but couldn't solve it. We will check with alcohol too. Yes, it is definitely a capacitor. Look for the alcohol drying on the bigger cap on the left. So, we must remove and replace the capacitor, but first we must remove and check if the short is gone and if the cap is the suspect. Yes, the short is gone. Now we will assemble the notebook and check if the notebook is alive. We have connected the cable of the screen to see if we have display. This is of course a partial assembly. We will connect the charger and the power on switch and test. Yes, the notebook is alive. We have display. The problem is no more.
That was the fault. As you saw, it was a capacitor that was dead. We have repaired this notebook. The client will be very glad about it. If you like this video, please like, subscribe and share. Thank you for watching.